Hello everyone and welcome. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to use Banker's algorithm to determine the current state is in safe state or unsafe state. So, to detect whether it's safe state or unsafe state, we need to find the need table. Before finding the need table, we need to create three tables first, which is allocation table, max table, and available table. So we are going to use allocation table and max table first. Available table will be used afterwards. So to find the need table, we need to use max table process to minus the process in the allocation table. So how? It's easy. You just use, for example, process 1. Process 1, the instance have 6, 5, and 4. And for the allocation table process 1, the instance have 2, 3, and 2. So you just take from the max table process 1, 6, 5, 4, and minus the allocation table process 1, which is 2, 3, 2. So just repeat all the calculation for all the process, which is 5 process, and you will get the answer to this for the need table. So make sure you calculate correctly, okay? Because one single mistake can mess up the whole thing. So after that, we are going to do safety algorithm. To do safety algorithm, we need to determine whether the available table is greater than the need table. Now how to do that is easy. We just calculated the process for the need table. So you just enter P1 and the instance for the need table in process 1, and then the available table, which is provided right here. We are going to use this for the safety algorithm. So just prepare all that, and now we are going to determine whether the available table instances, which is this, is greater than the need table. So let's do it together. So 2 is not greater than 4, so it's wrong. So 3 is greater than 2, yes. 5 is greater than 2, yes. But the answer is still false. Why? Because there is one false in the instance. So you might think that 3 and 5, they are correct because they are greater than 2. But 2 is not greater than 4. So if there are one false in the instance, the whole process is false. It's not true. So when it's false, we will just continue to the next process using the same instances for the available table. So now let's move on to process 2. So process 2, you write down the instances for process 2 need table, which is this 100. Okay, so the 100 less than equal 2235, because the previous process is a false. So we just use the same available table. So now we just look whether it is greater than 2 or not. So 2 is greater than 1, yes. 3 is it greater than 0, yes. 5 is it greater than 0, yes. So it's true. So there are no single one false. All of them, 3 of them, the instances are true. So the whole process is considered as true. So when the process is true, we are going to add the instances of the process from allocation table and calculate the new available table. So for example, this is true and this is from process 2. So we need to take process 2 from the allocation table. See, process 2, 3, 1, 3. So we just add the available table, and now you'll get 5, 4, 8. So afterwards, you are going to use 5, 4, 8 to determine others whether this is true or false. So I'm just going to skip ahead because this is actually simple. I'm going to show you the answers now. Okay, so after we have determined all the process whether it's true or false, we are going to execute all the false process. So as you can see, we only have one false process, which is process 1. So we are going to take this process 1 after we have completed all the instances. So now we just do the same thing. So just copy down the same thing, 4 2 2, and here we are going to write the total instances that we have added throughout this whole algorithm. So for me is 10.5.11. So 10.5.11 is greater than 4.2.2. So it is true. So that's all. We have done the safety algorithm and now we are going to move on to conclusion. So in conclusion, we need to conclude the safe sequence and whether the deadlock can be avoided or not. So to find the safe sequence, we need to go back to safety algorithm. So we start from P1, but P1 is a false. So we're going to look at P2. We just ignore P1, okay? So P2 is true. So we are going to start from P2. So just write P2. And then P3 is true, so you write P3. P4 is true, so you write P4. P5 is true, so you write P5. And just now we just execute P1 because it's false, so we need to make it true. So we'll put P1 at the last. So we already have the safe sequences and the system is in safe state and the deadlock can be avoided. So that is how you do Banker's algorithm. It's pretty easy. So thank you all for watching and goodbye.